हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू अवर न्यू सेशन कॉमर्स चैप्टर 8 मल्टीनेशनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। फर्स्ट चूज द करेक्ट आंसर। ए मल्टीनेशनल कॉरपोरेशन कैन बी डिफाइंड एज ए फर्म विच ओन्स कंपनीज इन मोर देन वन कंट्री। नाउ मूव ऑन टू सेकेंड क्वेश्चन। सेंट्रलाइज्ड कंट्रोल इन MNC इम्प्लाइज control exercised by headquarters. Enterprises operating in several countries but managed from one country is termed as multinational company. Fourth one, dispersal of decision making power to branches or affiliates subsidiaries by head office represent. Answer is decentralization. Coca-Cola company is an example of MNC, that is multinational company. Now move on to very short answer. First question, define multinational company. According to Neil H. Jacoby or Jacoby, a multinational corporation owns and manages business in two or more countries. So, multinational company is a company which doing the business in more than two countries. Write any two advantages of multinational company, MNC. MNC set up their facilities in low-cost countries and produce goods or services at lower cost. By providing super quality products and services, MNC help to improve the standard of living of people of host countries. Third question, give two examples of MNC. Bata India, Colgate India, Sony India, Maruti Suzuki, Timex Watches. So any two examples you can give. Next one, name the type of business enterprises which operates in more than one country. Bata Corporation, Colgate Palmolive, Suzuki, Timex, Sony Corporation are the enterprises. Next question, short answers. What are the advantages of MNC? This question asked in the quarterly and half-yearly both the exam. What are the advantages of MNC? First point, low cost labor. Here I given 3 points. Even if you write 1 point in one heading thoroughly, perfectly, that is also enough. So you read it at least 2 points in each and every heading so that you can remember at least 1 point word to word. So you have to write word to word points. First point, low cost labor. MNC set up their facilities in low cost countries and produce goods and services at lower cost. It gains cost advantage and sell its products and services of good quality at low cost. This is not available to smaller companies which operates at regional level. Second point, improvement in balance of payment position. MNC helped the host countries to increase their exports. As such, they help the host country to improve upon its balance of payment position. Next point, improvement in standard of living. By providing super quality products and services, MNC help to improve the standard of living of people of host country. So whoever purchasing the MNC product, so your standard of living will be increased if you purchase good quality of product. Second question, What are the disadvantages of MNC? Danger for domestic industries. MNC, because of their vast economic power, pose a danger to domestic industries. Domestic industries cannot face challenges posed by MNC. Many domestic industries have to wind up as a result of threat from MNCs. So, because of MNC company, our domestic industry means our country industries are facing a lot of problems. Second point, deprivation of job opportunity of local people. MNC may not generate job opportunity to the people of home country because it is a multinational company. So it will not give any profit, any job to our country people. Third point, no benefit to poor people. MNC produce only those things which are used by the rich. Therefore, poor people of host country do not get generally any benefit out of multinational company. So up to this, our 8th chapter is completed. Thanks for watching this video.